Kenny. Kenny, you're on the air.
You want to pretend?
Oh, gosh.
Kenny Allen.
That I'm a pilgrim? And you guys are Indians?
Okay. That would be fun.
All right.
That's the first Thanksgiving. Let's pretend.
That we can pretend.
All right.
And I'm like a robot pilgrim.
Okay.
Brother.
But you guys are just like regular Indians.
Okay.
You don't have any like superpowers like
right.
I do.
Right, because you're the robot pilgrim.
Sure.
Right. So now pretend that I'm eating a big turkey.
Okay.
And I'm enjoying it. And you guys just have, like, chocolate bars, and that's it.
Okay. For Thanksgiving?
Right.
All right, so the big robot pilgrim is eating turkey.
Why does a robot need turkey?
Because he's hungry.
So
why else?
Why else?
I guess you're right.
You're stupid, Fez.
Well, then how about we're Indians, and we have bows and arrows, and we steal that turkey?
Right.
No!
Why?
You guys are my friends.
Okay.
That's why we're eating together.
Then why aren't you sharing the turkey?
You need to be thankful for what you have.
Which is chocolate bars.
This is the worst Thanksgiving ever.
What's the first Thanksgiving, Fezzy? So it's, you know,
I guess
the worst.
I guess we don't know any better, and we're really glad just to have chocolate bars.
Yeah.
So now pretend.
Okay.
That robots are chasing us.
Right.
And I get my lightsaber that I have, and I kill them.
Right.
And you guys just try throwing rocks at it, but they're not, like, big rocks. They're, like stones.
Okay.
And it does no good, and I just kill it off with my superpowers, like, easily.
Okay.
What if we got on our horses and we started charging at the bad
No!
What?
You don't have any horses.
We're Indians.
Well, they didn't have horses yet, Fez.
Oh.
It wasn't until later.
I'm making up the rules.
Oh, yeah. He's making up the rules. He's the robot pilgrim.
I know, but it's no fun when he makes up the rules.
Just listen to the robot pilgrim, please. All right, we're pretending.
Pretend that I'm eating my turkey again.
Right.
And I hand some over to you.
Oh, thank you. Finally
sharing.
But then
I take it away and laugh. And everyone starts laughing at you.
Who?
The other Indians and pilgrims.
So even the other Indians having chocolate bars are laughing at us, too?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's funny. All right.
So why are we being humiliated on the first Thanksgiving?
So now pretend?
Yes.
Yeah.
That we start eating again?
Right.
And you start to choke?
I'm choking.
Yeah,
so now pretend.
There must be nuts in this chocolate bar.
That.
Yeah.
I give you the Heimlich maneuver.
Oh, brother.
You saved us. Mmm, plenty good, thanks, robot pilgrim.
I am not pretending.
Why? I'm the leader.
He's the leader.
Who says he's the leader?
Well, he's a robotic pilgrim. Of course he's the leader.
Just pretend.
Yeah. Just pretend.
Yeah, can't you pretend?
Pretend in real life.
Okay.
What?
This is really happening,
so
guys.
Pretend?
It feels like it.
That you guys got a new knife to defend yourself with?
Nice.
Good.
It's better than those stinking stones.
And you throw it against the tree and it breaks.
Oh, jeez.
And then everyone starts laughing at you again.
The other Indians and pilgrims?
Yeah, since that they have, like, guns.
Jeez.
And laser beams.
How did they get them?
Because they're, like, our special friends.
Well,
you guys are a special friend.
Let me and the other Indian have something to defend ourselves.
Yeah.
You got the knives.
Yeah,
you
but
broke
it broke.
Them.
Well, it is our fault. Yeah, pretend that our knives break, but then we get lightsabers instead.
No! Only I have the lightsaber.
And we start running around with these lightsabers?
Yeah, and we chase the robots away from the turkey. And
Indians didn't have lightsabers.
We get to eat the turkey.
Oh, he's
no!
right. Indians didn't have lightsabers. Only pilgrims did.
All right.
Robotic pilgrims.
I read that.
All right.
So now pretend?
No! When is this meal going to end?
It's Thanksgiving. It's a big meal.
It is a big meal. Oh, boy. All right, now what are we pretending?
Pretend that you guys got kicked out of the club.
What club? The first Thanksgiving's club?
Yeah.
Oh. Ew.
So pretend?
He's having too much fun tonight.
I know.
Yeah.
that we start running around you guys and throwing stones at you, and they're bruising you because you guys bruise easily? That's why you're always getting made fun of?
We can. We're Indians.
Why? Why can't you?
Pretend we call your mom.
No.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll call your mom.
No.
I will. I'm going to tell.
No.
Don't tell.
I'm telling.
Kenny Allen, don't tell. All right. Now he's telling, and we're all going to be in big trouble on Thanksgiving. Great.
You ruined Thanksgiving again.
Boy, that kid doesn't get along well with others.
You get along with one character who calls the show?
I don't think so. All really get under my skin.
Maybe when the characters call, you ought to take a little break. Because they all, you know, battle with you.
Martin I enjoy. Retard Martin. I get a kick out of him.
Ban the man!
Ban the man! Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. It's the Bennington Show. I'm Ron Bennington.
And I am Gail Bennington.
With us, our Thanksgiving crew from the big show. Let's put it together for a guy who did everything he could to make that special, not just for us, but for every single person in the audience. It's Chris Stanley, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Stan the man.
Stan the man. And a gentleman who just broke out this year, becoming the voice of the Bennington Show. Show our announcer, Vito Calise.
Yeah. Vito.
Yeah.
Vito.
Thank you.
And what about this legend in New York radio? A man who has worked with, well, I'm going to say countless people who are now in the Hall of Fame, but two. And that's a lot in this business. And by the way, a friend of mine from North Jersey, when they sang that song, they grew up listening to WNEW, and they always thought that Van said, Scotso, Scotso, Scotso. Black Girl Douglas, yeah! Everybody! Welcome Thank back, you. Girl!
Girl's back!
Girl!
And Gail Bennington, of course, who has brought not just herself and her husband, but our entire family something to be thankful for. The newest member who made her debut at the Thanksgiving show. Julia!
Yes!
So this is the day that we play the Thanksgiving show that we did at the Hard Rock, and everybody that came to together for that. But it's a really special night for us, and man, what a show that turned out to be, right?
Yes, we went big this year, and it was just a fantastic experience. Every year, it's our most favorite event where we get to see everybody, and the amount of people who showed up and came out, it was absolutely stunning for us.
And I kind of feel for all the people who didn't get in. I mean, we had thousands of people putting in for tickets this year. And when you go to theibag.com where we have all the pictures, I think it was Earl who took the picture of the line that went down the street, which we didn't get to see.
Yeah.
And when I saw it, I think yesterday, I was like, oh my God, I wish I could have ran down that line. I love all the people who showed up. Normally we keep everything secret, but social media has turned that around. So we want to thank all the people who performed with us. Big J. Okerson, TJ Miller, Jim Florentine, Luke Florentine, who came out in the heel role. Rich Voss and Bonnie McFarlane, Lisa Traeger, Joe List, Keith Robinson, Chris DiStefano, Giannis Pappas, Don Jameson, Crazy Jen, Big A, and Stalker Patty, and then our musical guest, Steve Earle, which is crazy, Johnny Resnick of the Goo Goo Dolls, and the great Tommy James. And then we closed the show down with a guy that we've always wanted to perform for us, and this is the first year he said yes, Don Wiki Wicklin brought the house down at the end of the show.
That was awesome. The shock from the audience.
So much fun. This has always been our family's big celebration day, probably more than any other time. It's a time that our family gets together. And we're all down on the Eastern Shore right now. First time that Juliet's going to be with my parents, and that's unbelievable.
Yeah.
Her great-grandparents, 91 and 88 years old, and send them pictures every day, and they're really looking forward to today.
Yeah, I'm really excited about it, and because it's such a significant holiday in our family, it's so perfect that this is kind of her introduction into the family officially, and yeah, it's wild to me that my grandparents are meeting my daughter, and it's so cool to me that they have got to see so many great-grandchildren.
It's unbelievable. I don't know how many, but this is going to be a very kid-leaning Thanksgiving.
It's crazy. Yeah, there's actually going to be a lot of little ones there this year, which is really cool.
Really back into kids' table time, which I can remember like it was yesterday sitting at the kids' table.
And isn't that weird how that happens? And I know other families do the kids' table, but there are times in your family's life where that goes away, right? Like most of your kids start to get bigger.
No more babies, Lay.
Yeah, exactly. No more babies until there is. And then like a whole new wave shows up. And that's just so wild.
So that's so fun for us. Chris Stanley, where are you right now?
I'm right outside Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania right now with my girlfriend's family.
You busted out there, huh?
Yep, mega busted down there. 7 hours. I will stop at a Subway, I found out, and there will be a stop at State College to vape.
I know you like meat, but can I recommend the veggie delight? It's delicious.
I can try.
There's no way, by the way, just so you understand this, that you have a 7-hour trip because you are going down, right?
Yeah.
Below where you need to go. I mean, you should be going just straight west when you leave New York City.
Yeah, that makes sense.
But you're going down to Philly. Then you're going upstate to State College and then back down to Pittsburgh. So, like, a drunk person might take this trip. Yeah.
Can't wait for the Wi-Fi to work.
And why are you going to a Subway instead of a nice fine Sheetz?
I believe on the stops there doesn't stop at a Sheetz, that there's a Subway like at a gas station. That's what I've been
told. Sheetz are gas stations.
I think this is an off-brand Sheetz.
That's what happens when you go Megabus and you don't go Greyhound. You don't like splurge a little.
Oh, yeah.
You went for the savings.
Yeah, I want the savings.
All I heard was the word bus. It's all the same to me. No, I never feel like, oh my God, I'm in a Greyhound.
No, he's on the coach of bus companies.
Hey, stop trashing my bus choices.
He's thankful that he's going with his girlfriend. And you're going to have you be the whole time with your girlfriend.
Yeah, it's going
to
be great.
Chance to get engaged or whatever you plan to do.
Oh my God, is this finally going to be the day?
Dude, if you got engaged to Thanksgiving, married at Christmas, and get her pregnant by New Year's.
Do it. Your like whole family is going to be like holiday fam.
Were you there for Thanksgiving last year?
No, I was not, no.
Mm. Yeah, you were.
No, I was there for Christmas last year. That's where I dropped all those F-bombs.
What did you do for Thanksgiving last year?
We spent time with friends of hers. Oh, we Friendsgiving.
Nice. Yeah, Brooklyn. Oh, yeah, those are fun.
Yeah.
Vito, where are you for Thanksgiving?
I'm in Pennsylvania. I'm at Saw Creek Estates.
Let's meet up, dude. Oh, yeah.
He's on the other side
of
Pennsylvania for you. Now, who's hosting? What's it all about?
It's my aunt. My aunt's like weekend house they have in the Poconos.
Ooh, yeah, nice. They're doing very well.
Yeah, super. And a school teacher doing very well.
How far are they from the lake?
I don't know. Every time I go there, I just go to the house and I don't do anything else.
Come on. You got to get out a little bit.
No, we go to that's it. We go up there. I maybe walk around the woods for a little and then I just go back into the house.
It's nice though to have a nice woodland walk.
It is cool. But
pics on your woodland walk. I'd like to see you in nature.
That's where me and Leslie
I've never
will
seen
be.
You around trees. How many people are going to be there, Vito?
I think like 12.
Nice.
Good size.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice. No, not a lot of kids.
Okay.
I'm sorry. Everyone in your family is barren?
Yeah, it seems like it.
Terrible.
They're all unfuckable.
Oh, okay. That's
incels.
Different.
Now.
It's a family of incels.
Yeah. Earl, what is your Thanksgiving plans?
At this moment, we'll probably be watching football with my father and probably hiding from all the kids.
How many kids are there? Just a million?
Oh, too many.
Yeah.
We got my great nephew is now one.
Uh-huh.
One was a four-year-old. It's going to be a lot of kids. Yeah. And a lot of drama.
Sure. Drama is what Thanksgiving is all about.
And then hey, off to the Hard Rock. Like probably like quarter to three. I'm like, gotta go. Gotta go to
that's
work.
That's nice. With the Hard Rock crew. And you're having turkey with them?
They always give us turkey and stuffing and
all a lot of affairs stuff. Taking place at the Hard Rock, from what I understand. A lot of at work affairs going down, which is always fun.
I mean, there's a couple of marriages that happen.
Oh, wow. I'm sure.
So you guys hook
sure,
it up.
Yeah.
They're like the North Star CITs.
Yeah,
you
they
know?
Really
they get together.
Are. So pity us. Earl, what does the family do for Thanksgiving? What's the meal?
Turkey, collard greens.
Yeah, mac and cheese.
Mashed potatoes, no mac and cheese.
What?
Pasta. So for some reason, pasta always
yeah,
pops
that's confusing.
Up.
Put cheese in it.
Doesn't make sense. Well, you know what I mean? Like a lasagna. And...
Yeah. You're not sure what the food is. That's for
no,
sure.
No, I'll eat it all.
Well, I know, but you don't pay attention.
Sweet potato pie.
Scotso.
Sweet potato pie for dessert.
Thanksgiving was a fantastic show this year, and something that I had thought about for a while, and that's, you'll hear it when, if you're a fan of the show, you already know that it happened. Fez Watley came back to be with us, and Fez is a literal part of the Bennington family and has been. I don't think people have any idea how close Fez is with my children and what.
Yes.
He being the fun uncle your entire life.
Absolutely. Yeah. I was so excited for him to be coming back to do this show and how much fun we were going to have on stage. And the day before he got here, I suddenly started to be like, I can't believe I get to also spend time with him.
Yeah.
Because he absolutely is my family. And I haven't seen him in a long time. And so it was so,
so
exciting.
He got to see the baby when he was excited about that.
Yeah.
The other funny thing was no one was expecting this because, you know, they've asked for it before. And then his health problems have gotten where they've gotten. So, but about... I don't know. It must have been 6 months ago. And I dropped a hint. Like, I'm really excited about something we put together for Thanksgiving. And Liz Sets Fire said, the only thing that we got is a Fez. And I'm like, oh, there's no possible way that'll happen. He's way too ill. But, and the fact that it stayed a secret, the fact the way the people exploded, the fact that, you know, Fez went from not performing for 3 years to walking out on that stage with that crowd. But to tell you, like, when I got the idea of how we would bring him out, and then we left it kind of loose, and then me, Gail, and Fez got together at his hotel room before the show, and how easy it was for the three of us. And then you brought up, we were always doing silly stuff together.
Yeah, I think this is just a unique thing for me because this is my first time doing that on stage with Fez. But even, you know, doing like bits and sketches at home, and even me and Fez doing like radio bits together when I was a little kid.
Yeah.
Bitby, very popular.
Bitby
the clown.
We should try to go back and find some of them.
I know. There was a great, there was that, and then also Dear Mimi, which was like a take on, what's her name? Anne Frank, but yeah. it was really weird. I've been doing that since we were
your
kids.
Entire life. You know, for every holiday or whatever, we did the What About Bob thing with.
Oh,
like,
yeah, absolutely.
So Fez would come over and I'm like, what is he doing here? All right, it's time for you to get going, Fez. And the kids would be like, he can't. It's raining. I know, it was so stupid. But we must have done that hundreds of times in our life.
Pilot high and deep.
Yeah. And he was like, we're all here for you, Mr. B. So to do that on stage was Just so much fun. It's a, I don't know what it is about Thanksgiving, but it, to me, it's always the purest of all the holidays. You don't really have to do anything but get together, you know? And it doesn't matter, you know, like we were saying, if you do a friend's Thanksgiving or a family Thanksgiving, but that whole thing about just taking a moment to be thankful and not even... not even tied in with what religion anybody is, just as a human being. Like, you could be an atheist and think, oh, I should really be thankful.
Yes.
For the, you know, the good things in
life. Absolutely. And it's something we never do, you know, on a day-to-day. And, yeah, I think that that's what makes it extra special is that, like, you just take a moment. And it kind of starts the beginning of the end of your year. Too. Like you start to go, what has happened this year? What is everything that's taken place? Because, you know, everything starts to wind down after Thanksgiving.
Yeah, it does. And it's wind down work-wise, but then there's the pressure now of the personal life. Like, is Chris Stanley going to... Look at her. She's playing with her toys.
Oh, my God.
She's just leaning over and playing with her toys. She plays with toys now.
It's crazy.
She's become a real toy
fan.
She's
like a real, like, kid now. It's very strange.
But, yeah, people feel the pressure of Christmas starting at this point. And if there's anything I could wish for this country is that we do away with that. You know what I mean? Like, it should just be Christmas, you know? Should just be a nice thing to do. I was coming over here today. Christmas has already started on Fifth Avenue. All the stuff is up. And again, you can be stressed by that or you could just be like, it's Christmas. It comes and goes.
So this year, you know, having a new baby, I feel like I'm going to give myself as little stress as possible. Because it's like, she can't, she's not going to remember it. There's not going to be like all this
None
pressure,
of us
like,
remember it. If I ask Vito, what did you get 5 years ago? He doesn't remember. What did you give your mom 5 years ago? Just chill.
Yeah.
Enjoy a little bit. Here's the perfect, I think, Christmas present. And that's the Bennington shirts. And they're available now.
You go to ibangshop.com, ibangshop.com to pick up the new Bennington t-shirts available now at ibangshop.com. And as long as supplies last, get a signed Bennington poster.
And thanks to everybody over at the Interbang, too. That's just an amazing partnership that we have. And quite frankly, they work harder than we do. I mean, we're a pretty... we're a pretty lazy bunch on this side. So, you know, we need people who care. Chris, I was a little disappointed that you didn't sing with Steve Earle. I know Copperhead Road is one of your favorite.
I love that song. I lost it when he was playing it, and I didn't think it was my place to jump on mic with Steve.
Well, you have a beautiful singing voice.
Thank you.
He does have a beautiful singing voice, but his dancing is kooky, and he was worried it was going to get laps. Because, you know, he's got that Scottish background, and he's doing that Irish jig, and it's just... Well, it's horrifying, is what it is. It's just horrifying. Earl, what was it like for you to be part of the Thanksgiving show this year, back after all these years?
Oh, my God, it was so much fun.
Yeah.
It was a blast.
What did your friends at the Hard Rock think about you working that crowd into a frenzy like you did?
They were shocked because I'm on the floor. On the floor. You're just kind of running around and doing different things. And they were like, oh my God, Earl, you got fans.
You do have fans.
And
you
maybe they'll look at you a little differently now, Earl. Earl was a big standout. Vito was a big standout doing his introduction. And our own Chris Stanley is beloved.
He is loved. He is so loved.
And the fact that you came riding out on, I don't even know what that thing's called.
That is a Swagtron hoverboard, Ron.
Yeah.
That's the official name of it.
If this was 7 years ago, that would have been thrilling. But it was almost like he was riding an antique out.
It's the wheels of destiny.
I was surprised, though, with the smoothness in which you did it.
Yeah, it looked really funny just because he had to lean forward. His hands at his side for some reason, and his fucking wife beat her, which...
That's extreme, Ron.
It was lazy, dude. You didn't go out of your way to get the costume that Vito did.
I know. Vito went all out. You just took something off. You were wearing less than what you usually do.
I also didn't time well how long it would take to take off clothes. So under my jeans, I had even more pads on.
We're going to do more timing next year.
Yeah.
We're going to do a better run through.
There was a moment where you were helping me put in kind of your producer hat on, and I realized that you were still in full pads. And I was like, at any point, you could have taken those pads off. There's no reason. You should still be rocking those pads through the night.
I didn't believe how cut he looked in that, whatever that vest is called.
It looked good.
What is that called, Vito?
I think it was dirt bike armor.
Thank you.
Looking really good.
We should thank the guy who has a beef with us, and particularly me, Hard Rock Johnny.
Johnny. Always the best, Johnny.
This is the first Thanksgiving I was ever badmouthed. So, made it kind of fun.
Well, that's Thanksgiving family drama, I guess. That's interesting. Yeah. Thanksgiving fashion.
Also, Rich Voss wants me to mention something. He said Rich Voss, Jim Florentine, and Ron Bennington will be appearing at Treehouse Comedy in Windsor Lock. Go to treehousecomedy.com for tickets. He's a promoter. It's another.
He is. As
he refers to it, another famous Rich Voss production, hashtag headliner, hashtag legend. All right, it's time to start this show off. And this is the fifth year that we've, which is almost crazy to me to say, because this was something that was just done as a quick whim the first time. And now we're 5 years into this, and it's like truly one of the great pleasures of our lives to get together with the people who listen to this program. And I think that radio is different than any other art form in the way that you think, oh, I could be friends with those people. I listened to that show. I could be friends with that people. And you can sometimes think that about rock and roll or movies or whatever. And it's just not true. But in radio, it's 100% true.
Yeah.
You know, because you have to share a certain aesthetic, I think, to sit around and listen to people in the show. Especially a show like this that is... Well, it's fairly unprepared, and the opinions come from all over the place. So there's nothing that we enjoy more than doing the show. And the fact that every year we make it bigger, and we, you know, we just sell it as our show. So you have no idea what comedians are going to be there, what performers, you know, we had some great rock and roll performers the last couple of years. So that makes it extra fun. And this was the debut of Juliet,
which was
surreal.
Very strange.
And even while it was happening, I wasn't a fan. I was literally like, let's get her off the stage.
Yeah.
Let's take her off the stage. Like the second you're walking out with her, I'm like, let's get her back out. That's plenty. But that was, you know, that was an exciting, weird thing for us to feel those emotions. So happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving to you guys. I'm thankful for you all.
Yeah, I love everybody in this room. And enjoy this. It's the Bennington family Thanksgiving.
Okay, look, we've been together 3 years. Who? The Benningtons. It's time for the Bennington family Thanksgiving show. And no, that isn't afloat in the Thanksgiving Day Parade, that's Chris Stanley. I'm Vito Calise, a.k.a. the Pilgrim John Wayne was always referencing. It's the only father-daughter radio show in the history of radio. It's Ron Bennington. It's Gail Bennington. The Bennington Show. Just like a middle of the
buddies! Wow! Thanksgiving in New York City! It's so fantastic to be here at this venue. You know, this is the old Paramount Theater in New York City. And this is a place where Frank Sinatra used to perform, Dean and Jerry. This actual room was the place for the first Elvis Presley movie was here. And now Vito was running back in stage like a fucking monkey. This city is falling apart.
This is also a really special place, a really special room to me, because last year, just a couple days before the Thanksgiving show, I found out I was pregnant.
So what happened?
I had a baby, dude.
Wow.
Yeah, you've met her.
Her. It's a girl, everybody. Wow.
I'm glad that we're bringing this up now. Just get this out of the way. I am a lactating mother, so this is considered splash zone right here.
Lucky seats, the lucky seats right here. This is so exciting. So, you know, it's kind of life-changing.
Yes, and this is like a big deal for us because, you know, we've always bragged. We're the only father-daughter radio show in the history of radio.
Yes.
And now, we're the only father-daughter granddaughter show in the history of radio.
Wow, I never thought of that.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty cool.
No.
It's time.
No.
It's time.
Is it happening?
It's time.
Oh! She couldn't be more weirded out right now. There she goes. That was her first appearance, and it looked like she hated it.
That's going to come up as a nightmare later. Like, that is going to resurface somewhere.
Yes. It's an absolute nightmare.
Bad mom. Bad mom.
You know what? I mean, your life is just taking off right now, and, you know, my life...
No, that's not true.
I'm kind of doing a countdown, if I'm being honest.
I am going to make this whole night about making you realize that's not true. I mean, we have great producers.
Oh, yeah, we do. You know, let me just say this. Some shows have producers, but we have an extreme sports team.
Thanksgiving returns. Here's your host.
Let's bring them out.
Vito Calise without the music.
Yo, there he goes. He's extreme. He's so extreme. Oh, my God, that's a really tiny bike. That is a tiny bike. Oh, my God.
Are you ready for this? It's the song.
Does he really need pads for this? He's pretty padded up.
Let's bring him out! Chris Stanley!
Y'all ready for this?
What the fuck? Convinced you?
No. That really convinces me that I made some awful, awful career moves. Yeah, this is nothing I'm happy about, Gail.
Come on, man.
My life really didn't turn out so good at all.
This is not true, dude. You are a legend. I don't want to hear you talk like that. Is this man a legend?
Legend? A legend? I don't know.
Yes. Do you know how many lives you've touched?
Not many.
How many careers you've launched?
One or two.
How many lovers you've loved?
That happened. That absolutely happened.
See, man, you're an icon. Let it sink in.
Not really, though.
What do you see when you look out at all these people?
Kind of idiots that really stood in line for a bad show.
Yeah, but they're here for you, man. I'm not gonna stop until you let this sink in. And that's why, Ron Bennington, this is your life.
What? What?
Ron Bennington, this is your life. Life herself, Gail Bennington.
Oh. Well, first I want to welcome someone back from your life.
Who's that?
Someone who you were best friends with for 18 years.
Is it Anthony Cumia?
No.
Because that'll get me in trouble.
A man who has been by your side through thick and thin.
Uh-huh.
The producer of the East Side Dave show on Compound Media. We all know him as the greatest American insult comic in the world. That was weird. Greatest American. It's Big A!
Big A.
Hey, Ron.
Oh, that's you.
Oh, I see Ron Bennington is here. I understand. You're a grandfather now.
Yes, I am a grandfather now, Big A.
Big A!
Let's have a drink to toast her.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. Oh, I forgot. You have a pansy to see. Alcoholic.
Yeah. Yes, I am.
You could just drink a shot of my jizz.
Oh, big it!
Big it!
I see. I see Ron and Benson's here. You're a grandfather now. At your age, you probably need to sit down and rest.
Well, yeah.
Yeah. So sit down on my big, big fat dick.
Yeah.
Yeah, I see Ron Bennington is here. I understand your grandfather now.
Yes.
You better keep up your strength by having a snack.
Sure.
I'll lean over and you can eat my farts.
Big A,
big A, everybody! Well, there he goes.
I'm sure you're convinced now, aren't you?
No, that was mean. And really scary when the word understand came up.
Well, I know this next one is really going to touch you. I'm going to bring up a young lady.
Mm.
She was once your confidant, your companion, your most trusted advisor, a ne'er-do-well society lady. Let's welcome her to the stage, Stalker Patty! Stalker Patty!
Stalker Patty!
Here she is!
Wow. Stalker Patty, everybody. Hey, girl. It's been a long time. You look good.
Thank you. Well, I'm very well, thank you.
Oh. I mean, how are you doing?
And it's great to see my Pooh Bear again.
Oh, Pooh Bear, that's right. No one's called me Pooh Bear in a long time.
Do you remember what you called me?
I sure do. My sweet taint. You remember that?
Yeah, like the time on 57th Street when you shaved my head bald and I wore a wig and you pulled it off.
Good times, huh, Patty? Good times.
And let's not forget the time I stripped naked and had to crawl on the floor through mouse traps with a Krusty the Clown mask on me.
You know something, Patty? You're not from my life. This is Opie's fucking life. I barely know you.
Pretty good. Pretty
Gail,
good
this
life.
Is fucking awful. I haven't really even had a life. I'm barring O&A's life.
Oh, okay. This next one, I promise you, is authentically your life. This is pretty exciting because I have a call coming in, a video call. It's going to be up on these screens here. Somebody who has not lived a public life in 3 years. Somebody who's gonna be calling
on, everybody. I will not take a call from that man. If I have learned anything in the past year, I could take my power back. I don't have to be a victim anymore. I'm ready to say that that son of a bitch, Fez Watley, abused me physically, emotionally, and yes, sexually, in both the mouth and ass for very many years.
Okay, hold on.
And I don't have to take it anymore.
If that had happened, why didn't you say this years ago?
Do not victim shame me.
You're right.
That man, Fez Watley, every day after we did a show together, would push me down and sit on my face. It smelled like old soup.
Soup?
And dryer lint. No, I'll never take a call from that man. He sat on my face, Gail.
Your face?
Yes. That son of a bitch. I finally have the power to stand up to him. And let me tell you something. I spit on the ground every time I hear the name Fez Watley. I am a victim no more. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you all. Thank you very much. I'm not a victim anymore. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate that. Thank you.
Well, well, well.
No!
Let me ask you, Ronnie. Is this what you missed right here? That's what you missed? Maybe you like it the new way. How about that? Huh? Little some of that?
No.
You remember the old soup and dryer lint?
How the hell are you still alive? 40 heart attacks. 79 stents. Diabetes.
Well, I got that from your sweet ass, baby.
Okay, hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Don't you see it's you? You're the reason he's still alive. Come on. Fez, isn't there anything you can say to make this right?
Well, I just want you to pour some sugar on me. Ooh, in the name of love.
How dare you? When you know Def Leppard is my favorite band, and then you use their lyrics against me.
I'm sticky sweet from my head to my feet. Forget the feet. Let's talk about you getting back on your knees, man.
All right. Okay. That's not appropriate. Come on. Guys, look.
You've heard of Me Too? How about these two right here?
No, that's too far. Now listen.
I'm just teasing my old twink.
Old twink is an oxymoron. It makes no sense. And you look like a fucking homeless wizard.
Guys, enough. Enough of this. Who wants to see a truce between Ron Bennington and Fez Watley? Who wants to see
no.
a truce? Will you do it, Ron? Will you make this town special again? Shake the hand that shook the world.
If I know Fez, that hand is covered in jizz. And I shan't touch it.
The hospital scraped that off after hospital after heart attack number four.
That's fucking disgusting.
Come on. Come on, guys.
Come on, take my hand.
Who wants to see them shake hands?
Take these three fingers. Take the whole hand.
That's not helping.
Have you no shame, sir?
Now listen, you guys are brothers.
I squirted my shame out all over your back.
Okay. Like every time I get him here.
Wait, I just want you to know that he called his cum his shame.
That's what mother called it.
Doesn't anyone in this audience want to see Ron and Fez reunited on this stage? Shake each other's hands, goddammit. Let's hear it.
My hand's right here. My hand's right here.
He's willing to do it.
It's clean.
If I shake your hand, will you go back to Florida and go back to fucking alligators and leave me alone?
If we shake hands here tonight, yes, I will go back to Florida.
See? Come on.
Yes.
This is a reunion.
Should I do it?
This is a once-in-a-lifetime reunion, guys.
So out of breath.
By the way,
I think I had two more heart attacks during that.
Fez literally showed me where these two things were to put under his tongue if he died up here. And I'm like, yeah, I'll do it, dude. But it would be fucking great radio.
Hey, Dad.
If you died. Dude, show everybody your zipper chest now.
I'm part of the zipper club.
Yeah.
Oh, stop it, sir.
Look at that. That's badass.
It's deep. They had to go in twice.
Yeah.
The surgeon forgot his keys.
I can't tell you how much that looks like your mom's vagina. It's unbelievable.
Well, the length, anyway.
Oh. Is he the best, Fez Watley, everybody? Wow, this is so fun. Thanksgiving in New York City, you guys. This is so fun. Now, we've been doing this for 5 years, and thousands of people have tried to get in here tonight without knowing who we have on the show. That's why we wanted to pop a couple surprises for you. So, we've got a musical guest that you're going to love.
You can see him at the 4th annual John Henry's and Friends show. It's happening December 3rd at Town Hall here in New York City. All proceeds and benefits to the Keswell School of Educational Program for Children and Young Adults with Autism.
You know, this is one of the greatest singer-songwriters in American history. He's on the 30th anniversary of the Copperhead Road Tour. Go to SteveEarle.com. Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Earle!
John Lee Pettimore. Same as my daddy as daddy before. I live a sovereign that I hate. Only come a ten about twice a year. 500 pound east since the copper line. Everybody knew it made moonshine. Now the river knew man on a granddaddy bed. Headed up a hollow leather thing head. For my time, I've been told. Never come back from Copperhead Road. Now daddy run the whiskey in a big black Dodge. Bought an option for Mason's Lodge. Charging and a share painting on the side. Shot a cooler primer in the two side. Well, him and my uncle pull the engine down. I still remember that rumbling sound. Come around the middle of the night. Heard mama crying when something wasn't right. Heading out of Knoxville with a weekly load. Smell the whiskey burning down Copperhead Road. Trash purse right here in Hawaii. Done two tools of duty in the headland. I come home with a brand new plan. I take sea from Colombia, Mexico. I plant her up a holler down Copperhead Road. Got a chopper in here. Wake up screaming like I'm back over there. I learned a thing or two from Charlie, don't you know? Better stay away from Copperhead Road. Copperhead
man. That was incredible.
SteveEarle.com to see that tour. Unbelievable. Steve Earle.
Give it up for Steve Earle.
This is the fifth Bennington Thanksgiving show in New York City. We'll be right back, everybody.
The fifth annual Bennington Family Thanksgiving returns. Here's your host, Ron and Gail Bennington.
I'm Bennington.
And I'm Gail Bennington.
Now, we already brought you Juliet, and we already brought you Fez. Who's ready for some street jokes?
First up, you know him from the Bennington Show. Please welcome the comedy stylings of Dish Gossip's Cashmere!
Cashmere's here!
Cashmere!
He's been running away from Fez all night. It's Cashmere.
Give it up for Cashmere, everybody.
Cashmere, you have a street joke for us,
yes,
do you?
I do.
Yeah.
A lion walks into a bar and asks the bartender for a job. Then the bartender says, why don't you work at a circus? And the lion says, why does a circus need a bartender? Cool.
That went well.
Cashmere, everybody.
That went well. Good.
He had a lion. No, you can stay up here.
Just stay.
He had a lion and a circus joke, and quite frankly, I didn't get it. Didn't understand it at all.
Next up, she is one of the stars of the new Netflix special, The Degenerates. It's Lisa Traeger!
Lisa Traeger is here!
Also,
Lisa Traeger!
Lisa! Give it up for Lisa Traeger!
You're over here. You didn't tell the joke yet, Lisa. Did you think you'd finished?
No, I'm just so confused. So just the street joke, nothing else.
Just the street joke.
A skeleton walks into a bar and orders a beer and a mop. Do you get it?
Yes.
Okay.
Because a skeleton can't really keep...
Lisa Traeger! She's performing Thanksgiving weekend.
You know, I gotta tell you this. Her Degenerate special is so goddamn funny. Make sure you see it on Netflix. It's amazing.
I watched it with my baby, by the way.
I watched it with my baby.
Let me just tell you this.
That TV is not a babysitter. Don't make the same mistakes I made.
Our next guest is performing with Jim Florentine in Newark, New Jersey, December 20th. It's Don Jameson!
Don Jameson is here!
Thank you, Ron.
Hey!
Hey!
Good to see you, buddy.
Good to see you, too.
Hey, smart move. No one's going to steal that wallet.
Voss has merch, by the way.
Lot of it. It's really not moving. One of them said Voss's 1989 tour.
The second decade in the business. All right. Street joke?
Street joke, buddy.
All right. What's the difference between $1 million and a kidnapped baby? I don't have $1 million in my van.
Oh! Don Jameson, everybody.
Don Jameson.
I'm just going to take a moment to check on Juliet.
As a new mom, I don't find that funny.
Changes everything, doesn't it?
I'm different now.
Changes all the perspective. As a millionaire, I wasn't crazy about it either.
Our next comedian is the co-host of the podcast, Three Girls, One Keith. Give it up for Keith Robinson!
Keith Robinson! Keith Robinson, everybody! Wow! How the hell did we get Keith Robinson? Yeah!
Yeah, motherfuckers! I'm gonna do an hour of fucking street joke.
You got a street joke at all? Or any
yeah, I
joke?
Got a damn street joke, man.
Okay. We'll take it personal, Keith.
I'm sorry.
Everything's cool here.
Boy, it looked like a place where white guys hide out at. What the fuck?
Now you know why Trump won.
Can I tell my street joke?
Just tell your street joke, Keith.
I'm going to tell a street joke right real fast if I can remember it. So it's like a sailor and a soldier. They die the same time, right? And they go to heaven, right? At the pearly gates, they're standing there. St. Peter greets them and says, I'm going to tell you guys something. If you have any dirty thoughts in your mind, you're going to lose your wings and they're going to fall off. So a nice angel walked past, voluptuous. And a soldier's wings fall off, fall to the ground, and he bends over to pick them up. And then the sailor wings fell off.
Keith Robinson, everybody. Keith Robinson! There's only one, man. There's only one. It's street jokes.
This is very exciting. I've just been handed this. Our next comedian, you know, from Silicon Valley, Big Hero 6 in the Deadpool movies, it's TJ Miller!
TJ Miller!
This is so fucking Rockstar Bennington! Look at how real this is. Hi, guys. Oh, it's been a dream of mine to perform at the Hard Rock Cafe. Just to do comedy right next to Philly cheesesteak egg rolls. It's so exciting. So I was gonna, do you mind if I do some quick ones?
Sure.
The funniest joke that I've ever heard. So real quick, so I'm a vaudevillian comedian, so I wanna do a couple of vaudeville doctor jokes at Dr. Run. This guy goes into the doctor. The doctor's like, I have good news, I have bad news. He says, well, what's the good news? The good news is you're not going to die. What's the bad news? You have amnesia, okay? What's the bad news? This nurse comes in and says, doctor, there's a patient in the waiting room, and he demands to see you. He says that he's invisible. The doctor says, tell him I can't see him right now. Man comes in, and the doctor says, I have bad news for you. The man says, what? He says, you don't have long to live. The man says, how long? The doctor says, five. He says, five what? The doctor says, four, three, two. So this is a joke from the 1970s. These are called Maria jokes. They're about housekeepers. They originated in California, the most racist state. And
And I've updated it to sort of be more in and of our times. So the protagonist is a woman. So this woman calls to her housekeeper. She calls home while she's at the office, and she says, Maria, is my husband there? And Maria says, yes, señorita. She says, okay, can you go and get him and put him on the phone? She says, lo siento, señorita, I cannot do that. She says, why not? Maria says, it's because he's in bed with another woman. She says, is this true, Maria? Really? Yes, lo siento, señorita, but it is true. She says, oh, my God. Maria, you've worked for me for how many years? Very long time, señorita. Okay. Are you in the study? Yes, señorita. Can you get in the top drawer in the desk, there's a gun, okay? I want you to take that gun, Maria, and I want you to go upstairs, and I want you to kill my husband and the woman that he's in bed with. She says, yes, señorita. There's a long pause, and then a crack. And then she comes back onto the phone. She says, Senorita, it is done. And she says, okay, thank you so much. Now I want you to wipe off the handle of the gun with a handkerchief and throw it into the pool. She says, I cannot do that, Senorita. She says, why not? She says, because you do not have a pool. She says, is this 555? And then this is the last one. So... I do a lot of begin to count and stop counting humor. Okay, so my older sister told me this one. I think this is the funniest joke I've ever heard in my life. So this guy wakes up on his 40th birthday, and he leans over to his wife, and he starts kind of trying to get something going, you know? And she's like, now, right now, I have a headache. And he goes, but it's my birthday. She said, no, go to work. So he goes to work. He gets there. His boss is like, it's your 40th birthday. What are you doing? Go home. Have sex with your wife. He says, well, actually, he goes, here's your month's paycheck in advance. Go home, have sex with your wife. So he heads home. He takes the long way home, and he passes by what's a known brothel. So he decides to go in. He says, do you know what'll this get me? Do you guys take checks? She goes, oh, yeah, we do. Takes him to the very back room. He has so much sex. He has more sex than he's ever had. He walks out of the place kind of walking bow-legged, you know? And it's very, very late. He gets home. He puts the key in the door. And he's going as softly as he can. He opens it up, and suddenly the door flies open. His wife puts a blindfold over his eyes. And she says, for your birthday, you have 3 wishes. She leads him into the living room and sits him down, right? She said, what's your first wish? And he said, can you get my slippers? She said, what? You want your slippers? He's like, yeah, they're in the bedroom in the back of the closet. She says, okay. And when he hears her leave, he pulls out his dick and he starts jacking off because he can barely get an erection. He's trying as hard as he can. He's really going at himself. You know what I mean? And then he hears her coming back in and he immediately puts his dick away. She says, what's your second wish? He says, can you get the paper? It's outside. She said, you want the paper? He said, yeah. Can you just go get the paper? It's outside. So she goes outside. Then he pulls out his dick. He's doing everything he can just to get a half a stock. He's putting his finger in places that he doesn't usually. He's licking his palm. He's fondling his balls. He's doing everything he can. Finally, he's half a stock. He thinks he can at least begin the act of sexual intercourse, right? So he puts his dick away. And then when she comes back in, he says, all right, I know what my third wish is. And she says, the third wish is mine. And she takes off the blindfold, and everybody in the room goes, surprise. Thank you very much.
DJ Miller, folks.
DJ Miller.
DJ Miller's got to go, everybody.
There he goes. DJ Miller. Our next comedian is one of the Bay Ridge Boys and the co-host of the of History Hiatus podcast. It's Yannis Pappas.
Yannis Pappas. Yannis Pappas.
All right, street jokes. Yeah, they're pretty bad. I could just probably just do my act. It's the same thing, no? Yeah, I grew up in Brooklyn, New York, so like the street jokes were always like pretty racist and like based on stereotypes. There was all these like, yeah, there was all these Polish, you guys remember like Polish street jokes? Yeah, for some reason they were just considered stupid people. And I don't know, that insult and stereotype kind of just came, it was like a left hook out of nowhere. I don't know if I've ever even met a Polish person. I don't even think I believe they exist. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know, let alone them being stupid, but... They were all racist, and the one that sticks out in my head was actually, you know, some black people stereotype. It was, why were so many black people killed in Vietnam? Because when the captain told them to get down, they all stood up and started dancing. There it is. It was the 80s.
Keith Robinson, not very happy with that street joke.
Fuck that street joke.
When they told him to get down, they all got up and started dancing. That is the most 70s joke that has ever been told. Lisa Traeger has no idea how that joke means anything. Who do we got next, Gail?
Next, from the Bay Ridge Boys, the History of Hyenas podcast, and he has a new Comedy Central special coming out in January, Chris DiStefano!
Chris DiStefano! Chris DiStefano!
Thank you. Thanks, Ron. All right.
Okay, there we go.
Yes, I, all right. So thank you. It's Street Joke Show. You know, it's one of those things where, you know, my, found out that my great-grandfather, he died in a concentration camp. Yeah, he fell out of one of the guard towers. That's it. I look like a Nazi. Fucking Nazi. They're bad people, but, you know.
Hey, Chris, we just found out that you got a telegram from Anthony Cumia that says, great jokes, stop. Got any more? Stop. Chris DiStefano, everybody.
Chris DiStefano.
He wants to stand next to Giannis. God damn, that web series that they do, the Bay Ridge Boys, is so goddamn funny. You got to check it out. Gail, who do we got next?
This is so exciting. This next comedian debuted on this show 1 year ago at the Thanksgiving show. Give it up for Luke Florentine!
Luke Florentine, everybody!
Luke Florentine!
Second generation comedian, Luke Florentine! What are you doing in Miami, dear?
You want to hear a joke? We'll deal with my outfit. Shut up!
I'm saying Luke, not Luke.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
He just went out.
All right, tell him the joke.
All right, you got a joke, right, buddy?
Mm-hmm.
Or is your only joke that jersey?
What's the difference between a vacuum cleaner and school? That a vacuum cleaner has to get plugged in before it sucks.
Oh!
By the way, Sam Darnold sucks and the Jets suck.
Oh! Sam Donald sucks, and the Jets sucks. And there's nothing we could say back to this kid. He is so wise beyond his years. Jim, you want to do a joke? Jim Florentine, everybody! The father of a Miami Dolphin fan.
I don't want to follow my son. I should have went on first, this fucker. So this lady walks into a pharmacy, goes up to the pharmacist. She goes, hey, can I have some cyanide? I want to kill my husband. He's like, I can't sell you cyanide. You're going to go to jail. I'm going to go to jail. So she whips out a picture of her husband fucking the pharmacist's wife. He looks at it. He goes, you didn't tell me you had a prescription.
Jim Florentine, folks.
And the Jets suck.
Jim, that was a beautiful, beautiful joke to tell in front of your child. Lovely.
Next up, he can currently be seen on Netflix, The Stand-Ups. He's one half of the Tuesdays with Stories podcast. It's Joe List.
He's on my list. That was
very nervous.
Yeah, that was a cool entrance.
Oh, thank you. It's an old gag. Do I just go? Oh. It hurts my feelings that they're not listening to my joke. Jesus Christ. Okay, so there's a doctor, and he's walking through the hospital, and he has a thermometer behind his ear. And then the nurse says, how come you have a thermometer behind your ear? And then he says, because some asshole has my pen.
Joe List, everybody. Joe, that was magic. This next comedian coming up is the greatest caller I've had in the history of my career, but the worst person I've ever met. It's Crazy Jen.
Crazy Jen. What's up? All right, Ron and B.
Yes.
I got a Christian joke for you.
Okay.
All right, just here we go.
Tell it to the audience
and
not to me.
I'm going to tell it to the audience. All right, listen. So there's a bunch of nuns, right? And their bus goes over a cliff, right? Yay. And so all the nuns die. And they go up to heaven. And there is St. Peter. And he says, all right, everybody, get in line. And so he says, listen, before we get into pearly gates, I got one question for you. He says, have you ever touched a penis? And so the first nun comes up, and she says, I touched it with my pinky. He says, all right, Mary Mother, go in there, wash your pinky. She says, all right, go through the gates. Second nun comes up. He says, have you ever touched a penis? She says, well, you know, maybe a little bit with my hands, all right? She says, go wash both hands, you're a little old. All right.
Go Jen, I'm just putting it there, washing it in holy water, right?
Washing it in holy water. Yeah, they're washing
that
it.
That may be helpful.
They're washing it in holy water.
For when we get to the end of this joke.
So then, this nun comes busting out.
Right.
And she's knocking the nuns over, and St. Peter's like, oh, wait a second. It's enough time. She's like, no. She was like, I know where Mary Margaret's ass was before I start gargling this water.
Thank you, Jen. You're back here. Thank you for telling some of that joke. It was like someone came in and cut out lines of that joke. All right, Gail, we got one more, right?
This is our final comedian.
You saw him here earlier tonight. He's still alive. Fez Watley.
Uh,
Oh, thank you. You're like a human defibrillator. What is the hardest part about riding a scooter? What? It's having to tell your parents that you're gay.
The whole street jokes crew. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, guys.
Thank you so much.
Street jokes rock. 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 Street jokes rock.
Some more exciting news for you. We got a performer that is going to sing for us, and this is very, very exciting.
This is so exciting. You can see him with the Goo Goo Dolls touring next summer along with Trey. GooGooDolls.com for tickets. It's Johnny Resnick!
Johnny Resnick, everybody!
Who?
So what do you think, Gail? Going pretty good, right?
That was fucking amazing.
Yeah. More to come. We want to bring out some friends right now. And this next gentleman is also part of Netflix's The Degenerates. And he is the co-host of The Bonfire on SiriusXM. And that podcast, Legion of Skanks, Big J. Okerson. Great to see you, Jay.
Thank you. Thank you.
Whoop, we got to get his mic on.
Whoop, there we go.
How you doing, buddy? How excited are you about the new Degenerates that you got
out? I'm very excited, man. It's doing well. Thank all you guys for watching, if you have.
And how are you feeling about your Philadelphia Eagles?
They stink.
Yeah.
They just stink.
Feels good to be back, though, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It's good to be home again. Coming up next, I believe this is one of the funniest comedians in America. You know her from her memoir, You're Better Than Me. She's one half of the My Wife Hates Me podcast on Riotcast. Bonnie McFarlane is here! Thank you, Bonnie.
You guys are here?
Yes. Bonnie McFarlane! Oh, she's going to be performing at the Chicago North Bar December 22nd. BonnieMcFarlane.com for tickets. One more time, Bonnie McFarlane. And honestly, I think this is one of the funniest people, and Jay and I talk about it all the time, one of the funniest comedians that we know.
Absolutely.
Now,
I've got nothing.
Yeah.
I've got nothing.
This next comedian is married to one of the funniest comedians. The other half of the My Wife Hates Me podcast. See his roast on bossroast.com. The one and only Rich Voss. Rich Voss. Nice to see you, Rich. Have a seat. And the way you're dressed, it looks like that caravan did cross the border.
After the show, I'll be selling these t-shirts.
All right, this is the new shirt? Yeah. All right. Why does it say MTV Spring Break on it?
Because I drove the comics there.
Wait, you're not going to give that one away for free to spark sales?
Is that how you do it? I'm saying,
he goes, here it is.
You just cost me fucking $25. Yeah.
Big J once again proves that he's only half Jewish. Which Voss sees as a weakness.
Take your shirt off!
Oh. No, that...
It's... For listen. One brief second, I thought they were talking to me.
You got... She got genuinely upset.
No, they want somebody with bigger tits.
Here's what I don't understand.
What?
Why, Bonnie?
Why? I have a martyr complex.
This next gentleman is the author of Everybody Is Awful Except You. His latest special is A Simple Man. And he's currently on the I Got the House tour. It's Jim Florentine. Now, Jim, good to see you, buddy.
Good to see you, too. I can't wait to buy a Rich Voss shirt after the show. I hope you have the square, because I don't have any cash.
On my phone, yeah.
I know Rich doesn't understand irony, but the guy who always has his shirt off is selling shirts.
No, first of all, I'm done. That's hack, okay? All right. I'm doing other things now. I'm doing other things. Fuck off. It's all men here. Why would I do that?
Well, this is fun. By the way, after this show, Rich is going to mingle. So, kind of fun for after he yells at everybody. Everybody here is a parent. Now it's time to play Robert Kelly's Creeps with Kids. Here's the thing. Robert Kelly's Creeps with Kids. Now, Bobby called just a couple hours ago and said that he had it's not a death in a family, but he said someone was dying in his family, and we believe that his wife just finished baking a ham. So he will not be here for his own game. And in other news, Mike Buschetti also said he had a death in his family.
What, his career is part of his family?
Oh. Take it off. But we're going to play without him because these are all great parents here. Well, you saw what Florentine said in front of his child. Things have changed, haven't they? You're okay with that, though, right, Jim?
Oh, yeah, whatever. I mean, he curses. I tell him you can only curse in the house, not anywhere else. Not in public or at school. If you do, I'm going to say, I don't know where he heard that from. Probably from his mom's house. Not from here. So in the house, he's like, fuck. I woke him up this morning. He's like, fuck, my back hurts.
Wait a minute. He wears Miami Dolphins gear. His back hurts. He's basically an old Jew down in Miami.
Yeah. It's true.
All right, so Gail Bennington has some questions about parenthood with these lovely... Why is this guy that looks like Tom Cruise just basked in purple? I honestly looked over and thought I just fell in love with Tom Cruise.
Thank God there's no cum on his face, or we would see it right now.
Yes. Yes, Jay. Oh, that's the only reason not to have cum on your face. You could walk under a black light.
That guy would look good even in a Rich Voss shirt. That's how good looking he is. How much after the show?
Only 25.
25?
Can somebody win this segment?
Yes.
Sure, Rich. We're playing for points. Unlike every other time you've done this show, this time, there'll be a winner. And the winner gets to go away with Blacklight, Tom Cruise.
And you can tell he's clean. He's totally clean.
What did you do?
That is true, Jay. Jay has pointed out that Blacklight Tom Cruise has no cum on his face and is totally clean.
It's the first thing I look for in a man.
Well, there.
I know.
Something different,
I know.
Huh?
If only I'd had a Blacklight when I met Rich.
Oh, shit. Artie Lang just showed up from last year.
Don't even joke, because I'm really afraid that's the death of Mike Buschetti's family.
Oh. Oh, shit. Why are you laughing at that, you creep?
All right, these lovely, lovely parents are going to give Gail some much-needed advice she has.
I'm new to this.
Wait, yeah, Ron.
Yes.
Is that the guy from Demolition Man right there?
Yes.
Oh, my God, the black light moves? Can we check everybody for cum? What? Oh, man.
It's horrible. You know, for the first time in the history of comedy, a funny lighting man. That's unbelievable. All right, Gail, each one of these brilliant parents is ready to help you right now. So go ahead and ask the first question.
Okay.
On creeps with kids.
Rich, this is for 15 points.
Or two Rich Voss shirts.
My first question to you, do you give your kids chores?
Do you give your kids chores? Let's go to Jim Florentine first. Now, that little gangster that you're raising, who only says fuck at home.
Maybe in a car too. And
why would he say it in front of his friends?
No, because his friends will tell the moms and then they won't hang out with him.
Yeah.
That's my theory.
Yeah, that's the cool kids. Does he have any chores at home?
No. I don't get many.
Does he have chores at his other home?
I don't know. I don't know what goes on over there. Probably. He probably has some shit he's got to do there. No, I just, like, whatever. I just tell him to get me a beer. That's about it. You can open and take one quick sip, and that's about it. He did drink some of my vodka and soda one time. He thought it was water, and he's like, yeah. Dad, that tasted weird.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. In about 10 years, you're going to love how it tastes.
Yeah.
And then he was drunk, and then he went to bed early, so it was perfect.
One quick sip, and that's the same thing as
yeah,
Bill
Cosby.
Yeah,
he's a lightweight at 8 years old.
Yeah. Well, you know, not all kids. Rich and Bonnie, do you give out chores?
Do you consider a hand job a chore?
I don't. Bonnie says yes. Is Bonnie, your mic isn't working? Okay, we need another mic for Bonnie.
Bonnie, why? I guess here's the deal. My kid came up to us the other day and said, I wanted an allowance. And I said, talk to your mom. And we said, if you...
Because he doesn't make any money. There. The secret's out. This shirt thing is the last fucking idea he has.
I'm going to try to sell a TV show around it. No, I guess... Good luck. We do... you know, we'll say clean your room, you know.
If you've got nothing, stop talking.
What's that? No, he's asking a real question.
Oh, I didn't know.
I already, fuck off. You look like a fucking elf with
35
AIDS.
Years in the business. Good comeback, Rich.
You know, Barney, you always said he was the best counterpunch.
Best counterpunch. You just saw it in action.
Hey, fuck off.
That guy could
honestly,
buy a shirt.
When he undoes the top button, he's much better.
I'll let Bonnie answer that one.
Yeah.
I tried doing it wrong. I said to clean her rooms, and I heard her, this is the truth, I heard her, she was watching a how to sweep tutorial on YouTube. So that's...
These kids today, right?
These kids.
With their Atari games and their hippity-hop music. Jay, do you have your daughter do any chores at all?
Well, she lives with her mom. I think she tells her to, and then my daughter doesn't do that. But then when she's with me, I just like spend a lot of money on her to buy her love because I don't have a lot of time. So, maybe?
Yeah. So, I would say, Jay, that you were a weekend dad, except for I know for a fact that you work weekends.
It's true. I'm a Tuesday night dad and Sunday afternoon dad. But I'll tell you what, we cram it in.
I'm a weekend dad.
Yes. Your weekends are free.
That was the joke. That was the...
Yes, I was with you.
Yes.
All right, so... So far, it looks like none of them have any chores.
My next question to you, would you ever want a little brother or sister for your child?
Oh, great question. Now, what about, we'll start again with Jim Florentine. Would you have another little brother or sister for your Luke?
2 days after I got divorced, I got a vasectomy, so fuck that. I'm out. I said, I got tricked once, never again.
Now, also, he's getting a little brother or sister,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, he is. From his mom's side, he's getting a...
From his mom's side.
Whatever, yeah. So he's getting a stepkid, right? Yeah.
It's
a half-brother, yeah.
It's not...
So he's excited. I mean, he's going to be a big age difference, but... You
know. Right. Now, it's...
I said, you're going to know him for, like, the first 2 years of your life, because then they're going to get divorced, and then maybe... If you guys are on the same child custody schedule, you'll see each other. Other than that, just enjoy 2 years, his first 2 years. Because if I got him the first half of the week and he's with the second, then we're never going to see your half-brother. Might as well tell him early what's going to happen. I already know.
I mean, it's nice to tell him early. I don't know if that bluntly. Jay, well, let's go to you. Would you ever consider, like, a little... playmate for your daughter?
Not for me, but my... It's a complicated situation.
Sure.
My ex-wife and me technically still are married. We never got divorced officially. So, but after we split up and I left, she got pregnant by another guy and now has a 3-year-old daughter. My stepdaughter on paper? So, maybe?
Now, is she with that guy? Is she with your step?
No, that's going to become my financial burden. That's a whole story, Ron. That's a whole other story, buddy.
Yeah. And this is a really good reason to stay on the road, isn't it? Now, Bonnie, would you ever make another mistake?
The amount of fucking brain activity I have to do in order to fuck them is insane. What I have to go through to get myself... The it's like I just lay there and I go, you're in your quiet place, and then wait for it to be over. I think that's how you get like split personality disorder. Yeah.
Well, here, if you ever really need to think of something, do what me and Jay do, and it's Blacklight Tom Cruise.
Sorry, I didn't know that.
Yeah. Blacklight Tom Cruise.
I'm gonna think of him.
Come free since 7 p.m.
Now, you've got older.
I got
kids.
Yeah, and first, I mean, I got 3 kids, and I'm not gonna waste a blue pill to take a chance that she's going to get fucking pregnant. You know what I mean?
No.
That went fucking nowhere.
Well, because they're expensive. He doesn't want to just take one. And they're like, what, $50 or something?
Well, no. Dr. Steve sends them to me for free.
Oh. Then how come I had to pay you $25 one time to get out of it?
No, I have 2 older daughters, one's getting married. So I'll probably have a grandkid soon, you know. My one daughter, not the one that lives with a black guy, is not getting married. The other, the one I talk to, she's the one who's getting married. And so I'll probably have a grandkid, you know. And then my daughter Raina could play with the grandkid, you know what I mean?
But what if Bonnie said, I want another kid? What would you say?
What would I say? Yeah. If sell a movie, you know. Fucking do something. I'll have another kid. You know what the fuck? Look at me. I mean, my shit is dope, bitch. 61. I'm fucking still dropping out of my dick.
Dropping?
I don't shoot.
Oh.
It falls the fuck out.
So when he comes on my back, I just let it evaporate.
if she
That's
wants,
why nothing showed up with the black light with you.
If she wants me to come on my face, I gotta do it like that. Am I, you know what I mean?
Wait, come on your own face?
No.
Why?
Her
Put
face.
Put the black light on him again.
Not my face.
I don't know what's happening in those hotel rooms on the road, buddy.
Fucking lonely, man.
So, Gail, I hope that was very helpful.
It was really helpful. My next question to you guys, do you help your kid with their homework?
Yes. Oh, we got to go to Rich. Boss first. Rich.
What?
Do you ever help your kid with homework?
Well, if there, you know, if there's a lot of questions about, like, you know, say, like, Frank has 3 vials of crack, and he said, no, I don't fucking. Homework? What the fuck? I quit school. Look at me. I can't help her with her homework. My kid's a straight A student because of her.
Bonnie,
right?
It's all you?
She's fucking brilliant.
Yeah.
Let me tell you.
Hold on. Fucking. Bonnie's brilliant compared.
Oh, see, now you're on to me. You understand now what
Bonnie
I've done
is
here.
My own personal autocorrect. I swear to God, man.
Yes,
fucking
we know, Rich. What about you, Big J?
I had my daughter when I was 23, so I did used to help her with her homework to get it done with, so then I could go back to playing video games.
That is such a Philly story.
Well, Ron, I guess what I'm saying is, maybe?
I'm sorry, Rich. 15 points for Big J.
Points.
Jim Florentine, do you help your kid with schoolwork?
No, we have some Indian neighbors that just moved in, and there's kids that are Luke's age, about the same age, and they're over constantly. I feed them, I do whatever. I basically take care of them, and they do his homework for him. I was so excited when they moved in next door. I found out they were Indian. I'm like, this is fucking beautiful.
Yeah.
And they help them all the time.
Yeah, until you.
It's very white collar bullying.
Yeah.
Until you try to sell your house.
Yeah. The only downside of this, when you said Indian, you meant Native American. Gail, next question.
My next question, are you involved with your kids' style?
Are you involved with, like, the way they dress?
Oh.
Rich Voss.
I fucking bought my daughter two of the coolest jackets at Kohl's, right?
Okay.
Like, it wasn't real leather, but it was fucking biker. I mean, it was fucking nice. And I said, I'll get you a couple tattoos, and she won't wear anything I fucking buy her. She won't wear it. I don't know, maybe I don't have good taste.
No.
That's not true. That is not true.
No, Rich.
Bonnie, are you involved with your daughter's style?
No, she has her own thing going on. I think she looks like, she's like a pot dealer. That's how she dresses. And it works for her, for some reason.
Bonnie grew up on the farm. Bonnie used to make her clothes years ago.
Molly Ringwald?
What's that?
Yes, it was exactly like
sewing
that.
Her dresses?
So Bonnie used to make her own clothes, and you're not keeping that going now to save a few bucks?
No, I'm a high... Come on. Fucking look at me. I spend money, man.
Yeah, I know you do, man. Hey.
I made the t-shirts by hand. Yeah. So that's a selling point.
Hey, Rich, easy, essay, easy.
I know, he looks like an extra from Blood In, Blood Out.
Now, Jim Florentine, do you help your son Fonzie with his clothes?
He just gave you the finger.
Hey.
Hey. This isn't in the house.
Only at home. That's for home.
The one you'll never be able to resell.
Well, I do like the Miami Dolphins in football, so I obviously dress him.
Yes.
What, you're a Jet fan?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, why? Good,
yeah. They're doing pretty good.
Yeah.
So I do help him, but... Yeah, exactly. Go Osweiler. But yes, I do dress him. But then he wears whatever he wants. Like the kids, they wear like the fucking their socks up to here now, outside the pants. So I'm like, all right, if that's what's going on.
I'm pretty sure that's not true, Jim. Unless they're riding a bicycle. Yeah.
In my neighborhood.
Those kids are called baseball players.
Well, I don't live in the ghetto in South Plainfield, so I wouldn't know.
Well, I grew up in Plainfield.
All right,
South Plainfield. I
don't know. Some one of them.
This got ugly fast, didn't it? All right.
Jay, do you help your daughter with her style?
I don't give her any style, but she just dresses like a regular teenage idiot. And then when she comes over with stuff that's too much, I just insult her out of it. So...
And now are you wearing your gloves like that when you do it?
That's right. First of all, Rich, for parents, everyone on this panel looks like an asshole. None of us look like parents. But no, she came over wearing like, what was the one? Fake eyelashes. That was the worst. I don't know why her mom, maybe it's the Hispanic thing, but my daughter came over and the eyelash was like on shitty with the glue. She looked like a dead Vegas prostitute. So I can't not say that to her. So maybe?
Yeah.
I guess it does help. She doesn't wear them anymore.
Big J. Okerson with 30 points.
Points.
Rich Voss with 0.
Go, get the fuck out. Yeah. I got at least 20.
All right, 20. And I'm taking that away from Florentine since his kid gave me the finger. All right, next question there,
Gail. All right, this one is very important. What is the best way to discipline your child?
Best way to discipline, and by the way, Jim, I hope you say punch him in his goddamn face.
The best way is miles from where anyone can hear you scream.
I make
take a long drive. Yes, go ahead.
I make my daughter listen to Chip Chipperson for an hour.
You know, it's great to have her spend some time with her real dad. You know,
That's insulting me now.
All of a sudden, Bonnie has a cock now. 10 more points.
All right. Everyone is in charge of giving themselves points. What about you, Jim? Seriously.
I usually don't discipline him. He's usually pretty good. If not, I just shut the TV off for a little bit. I don't put him in his room or any of that shit.
Yeah. You just shut off the TV.
Yeah, just for a little bit. But he's pretty good, so I really don't have to discipline him. He cursed around the house like, fuck you, Dad. I'm like, yeah, I kind of like that.
Right. What would make you turn off that TV for a little bit?
If there's like a naked scene in a movie, I'm like, close your eyes and go get the hand cream.
Yeah. You know, there is the occasional naked scene in a porn. Yeah. So I guess he stays a little bit of trouble. What about for you, Bonnie? I like
no porn in public. No porn. That's how you teach your kid. It's okay at home. Didn't he say that about cursing?
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry. Thank you. Doing great. One of the funniest comedians in the world. I don't know. I guess the best way to discipline a kid is to separate them from their parents and put them in a cage. It's political.
They remember it.
Edgy. Edgy comedy. Bonnie McFarlane has given us. Jay, are you like a disciplined guy at all?
Yeah, my daughter's not talking to me right now for the last 2 days because she fucked up enough. She's been told she was going to lose her phone a bunch, and then we took it away yesterday and got her a flip phone. Shut her down. Hasn't talked to me in 2 days, but here's what. Her mom's all freaked out, but I'm like, she's going to talk to me. I've organized her life that she needs me. She has to come to me for things, so she's going to have to give up at some point and deal with a flip phone.
You know, like it was 10 years...
Wow, I didn't realize the crowd. That's why they thought I was a monster. Yeah. Monster. You know, how's she going to Twitter?
Yeah.
You can...
10 years ago, kids used to beg to get a flip phone. And yeah.
Yeah.
Now, I know for a fact that a flip phone comes along when you buy that shirt that Ross is wearing. Comes with a free flip phone. Do you do any of the disciplining now?
Because my daughter, she's so cute, like I'll yell, and then it's hard because she's just a doll, and I love her so much, it's so hard.
Oh my God.
Are you talking about Bonnie?
Do not buy into this. I say to him that this is his problem, he's just all bark. He just yells at her. She just tunes it out. She doesn't fucking care. It's just like when he's on stage, same thing. Just tune it out.
Like,
you know?
Mother, like daughter. See, they both team up on me at home. They fucking, but listen, I'll say don't do this or don't do that, you know, but, you know, she listens to her mom so much, and you know what I mean? Not a great example. But she's just so cute. It's so hard.
It's not,
you know,
gross.
She said before I come here tonight, she said, Daddy, I love you so much. If you could sell 10 shirts tonight.
I'll still never go to college. But...
Who needs college?
Yeah. Yeah. That kid, no chance in college with him as the dad, right? What are we looking at?
Publics? No, she's a straight A student.
Yeah.
She went to fucking coding camp and to 3D printer camp, and all the kids in her camp were, they were Asian and Indian, and they're the smartest kids on the planet, and my daughter was number one in her fucking camp. There was only one other kid.
Yeah. How old are the kids? 5?
No, they're 10, 11. My daughter's...
I always love when fatherly pride and racism go hand in hand like that.
Especially because those Asian kids' parents killed them after they found that out.
One of them jumped in front of a train.
I can't go home and tell my parents this.
Yeah.
No, that's not racist saying someone's smart, is it?
Let me just tell you something.
We got a 3D printer. She took 3D printing last summer. And Rich would get that 3D printer out. He wants her to print a gun. I don't know.
T-shirts? Is that what she's doing? Is that what he calls a 3D printer? He's got a fucking silk screen going in the garage.
Or Raina's making Rich Voss action figures at home.
But...
Oh. He came up with my CD cover. You're fucking great. Jay's my publicist.
By the way, Florentine's kid got a C and Jim took him out for pizza. All right, last question, Gail.
This is the final question. What is the right age for the sex talk? Is the right age for the sex talk?
Oh, I'll take this one.
Jim?
Probably like 11. I think, I hear his friends already saying they watch wrestling. There's this one female wrestler, Alexis Bliss or whatever, and they talk about how to get hard-ons and their penises hurt. But then when Ronda...
He just put his hat over his eyes.
But when Ronda Rousey's out there, it goes down, so they already know what's going on, but, you know, and I
Luke,
just...
Luke, is that right, buddy? Is that what's going on? With your friends right now? You're number one. You're number one, pal. Wow.
Where am I? This is fucked up.
So I think about 11.
This is not cool.
Yeah, I know. Rich and Bunny, have you had to talk?
You know, I don't know if I need to talk. I don't know.
She's explained it to him.
Bonnie, this is kind of... I shouldn't... Bonnie was taking dishes out of the dishwasher because that's... And my daughter walked behind her.
She is a fucking creep. I was taking pictures with my friend, and I got Raina to take a couple pictures, and we were doing something. She goes, now kiss. She's a fucking creep.
Yeah. So, did you?
They know everything, these kids, you know?
Right.
My daughter's watched every episode, everyone, the Family Guy, so that's where she learns everything, you know?
Yeah, so that's where that A student learns everything, Family Guy. Jay, the sex talk.
I mean, she's 16. I don't think we ever officially had a sex talk. Her mom probably did with her, but when she got caught drinking, I was like, you know, this leads to you being a whore. You know, you know what a whore is? And she was like, yeah. I was like, don't be.
And that should was do it.
Yeah. You know, and we kind of nodded and we're like, I get it.
I got to use a bad word here.
Yeah.
Whore. Rocky knowledge.
I mean,
Rocky knowledge from Philly.
She's watched my set a bunch. So like, if she laughs, I go, that's it.
That's it.
See, you can get a repeat customer.
Hey, you guys, Creeps with Kids, let's hear it for them. Big J. Okerson, Boston Bonnie, Jim Florentine.
Thank you, Ronnie.
One more time, the Creeps with Kids. Love them. We're gonna do this, so go ahead and take them off.
This is Ben.
The mic's off. There we go. No, I think it's back on. Try it.
Do we get it?
Yeah.
This has been a phenomenal night. Thank you all so much. I want to take a moment to say a couple of thank yous to people who have helped us out. Hard Rock Johnny,
Hard Rock Johnny,
staff.
Everybody.
Deb from the Interabang. The Creeps with Kids. All of our Street Joe comedians. Steve Earle. Johnny Resnick of the Goo Goo Dolls.
Wow.
Steve Leeds, Eric from Sirius's Music Department, our house band, Strange Magic.
They were great. So
Ian,
great.
Thank you so much, Ian. And of course, thank you so much to Fez Watley.
Fez Watley here.
Kate's going, what? Now, I also want to tell you this. We got the new Bennington shirts, which is the logo, except for Gail is holding the baby. And we're selling them out front. Fezzy's going to be out there with us tonight signing shirts if you guys want to come along and say hi to him. But it is so great to have him back here and all the help that we've had. All the comedians that were here tonight, too.
Give it up.
It's so much fun. Now, I got to tell you something. I am a gigantic fan of songs that are about and originate in New York City. And to me, this is one of the greatest of all time.
23 gold singles, 9 platinum albums, over 100 million records sold worldwide, 32 Billboard Hot 100 chart hits. It's Tommy James!
Tommy James, everybody! Moni Moni!
Moaning, moaning. Shoot 'em down, turn around.
The great Tommy James, everybody.
Tommy James.
Wow.
Get Together with Tommy James airs Sunday at 5 p.m. on SiriusXM. 60s on 6.
That
Tommy
was
James.
That was unbelievable. Hey, let's bring back Vito, Earl, Chris Stanley, and one more time for Fez Watley. Let's hear it for the band who's been up here with us all night, too.
Stage Magic, thank you so much.
Boss, come on out. Who else have we got? Anybody? Where's Fezzy? Big J. Fez Watley. We're going to end this. Black girl, get out here. Fezzy, you remember 15 years ago, this guy brought us into XM radio, and he's going to take us out tonight. Our friend of the last 15 years, Don Wicky Wicklund. Take us home, big man.
Come on, New York City! Awesome, love it. The past 15 years, thank you so much, Ron and Fez.
She gets now and it seems to me reminds me of childhood memories and everything was fresh in the bright blue sky.
For the last 15 years. Thank you guys so much. Have a great Thanksgiving, everybody. All the comedians that were here tonight, all the great, great rock and roll that we've got to cheer. And Gail, one more time.
Strange Magic, everybody.
Fez Watley, folks. Take care, everybody. Thank you so much.
Happy Thanksgiving!
We'll be back signing some of those shirts. See you in the lobby.